Hey there, Virgo. This is Renee. Welcome back. Virgo, this is going to be your reading, a general reading for you. So let's take a look at your energy. We'll jump right in. Okay, what's going on with Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising, and Venus? Okay, we have honesty. I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. Okay, so I feel like, you know, you're looking for some honesty, some kind of finding answers, you know. We also have gratitude. I am thankful for this life and the opportunities that it presents. So I feel like you're surrounding yourself with a feeling of gratitude, okay? Okay, let's get some more energy for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Okay, this one wants to come. Okay, we have balance. Yeah, see, I feel like, you know, you're trying to find the truth of the situation. You're trying to find some kind of balance, okay? We also have wisdom. So I definitely feel like you're looking for some kind of knowledge. There's some answers that you're looking for. And I feel like, you know, you're actively seeking these answers, okay? But, you know, I feel like those answers are going to come to you. Let's take a look at the tarot. Let's get more messages for you. Message for Virgo, please. Sun, Moon, and Rising, and Venus. What do we have for Virgo, please? Sun, Moon, and Rising, and Venus. Message for Virgo. Okay, we have the Eight of Cups. Wow, the Three of Wands. We have the Three of Cups, the Five of Pentacles, the Four of Cups, and the Queen of Swords. There's that needing to find answers. Okay, at the bottom, we have the Three of Pentacles. So I feel like you may be teaming up with somebody. You may be collaborating, you may be asking for advice, but I feel like there's someone around you who is offering some kind of valuable information to you. You may be working with someone, working with a mentor, if this is a job situation. But I feel like, you know, you are... I want to say in cahoots, and I don't know why that's coming into my mind, but I feel like you're in cahoots to find some information. Okay, so you may be actively searching, and I feel like you may get a friend to help you find out the answers that you're looking for. Okay, so very interesting, Virgo. Okay, I feel like there may be something that you may be walking away from. There's something that you may be letting go of because I feel like you're looking for something better. You're looking for a better situation that's going to bring you more stability, more love, more support. Okay, this Three of Cups card, this is my card of support, needing to find support. For some of you, now this isn't going to resonate with all of you, but for some of you, I feel like you're leaving a situation looking for something better because there may have been a three-party situation that you were part of and you're kind of done with it. You're ready to leave that situation and move on to greener pastures. Okay. So we're going to clarify that information. Okay. We have the Five of Pentacles, the Four of Cups, and the Queen of Swords. So I feel like you feel like you don't have all the answers, like you don't have all of the knowledge that you need at the moment. I feel like you're constantly thinking and you're caught up in your head. You're like overthinking the situation over and over. Like, you know, where is this situation? What's going wrong here? You know, what is happening? Because I feel like you're trying to get a better understanding, okay? You're trying to understand the situation, but I feel like, to be totally honest, Virgo, I feel like there's no need to do that because you already know the answers. You're just kind of fighting the situation because you may not want to accept the truth at the moment, if that makes sense. But I feel like things are becoming more clear. You're going to find the answers that you're looking for, but they may not be the answers that you want to hear. Okay? So I think that is something that you may have to come to terms with. Okay? So let's clarify these cards for Virgo. Let's clarify these cards for Virgo, please. Message for Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Okay, with this Eight of Cups, we have the Queen of Pentacles. Wow. With the Three of Wands, we have the Nine of Wands. With the Three of Cups, we have the Five of Cups. With the Five of Pentacles, we have the Eight of Wands. With the Four of Cups, we have the Nine of Swords. And with the Queen of Swords, we have the Lovers. Okay, so we have the Eight of Pentacles at the bottom. So I feel like there's something that you're working on. But this is something that you're finding out what it takes to make something happen. Okay, the Eight of Pentacles, this is like being a master of something that you're doing. You're kind of... You've totally got the hang of it, and now you're kind of like a pro. You're just ready to take off, ready to get it done. And I feel like there's some situation that you're in where you are finding more information about. You're becoming a pro in your situation. Maybe you're taking full control. Not maybe, you are. You're taking full control of the situation. You're just going to get it. You're totally adapting to whatever the situation is. You're like setting the place on fire, Virgo. Finding your happiness. Beautiful. Yeah, there's something that you're doing. You're doing the right things, Virgo. I can't say that for everyone around you, but I feel like you're on the right track. You're moving at the right pace, going the right direction. Okay, so I feel like whatever this is, I feel like it's going to work out for you. Because with this Eight of Cups situation, you know, there's something that you're letting go of, yes. But you're finding something that's much more better, much more suited to you. What much more valuable than something that you left behind. And I really feel like you're being fearless at the moment. You're not thinking about the things that you lost because you're preoccupied with these new opportunities, with this new blessing, this new gift. Okay? Look, she's holding this pinnacle up like it's a gift to heaven. Okay? So I feel like whatever this is, you're putting a lot of value into this situation. Okay? And I feel like with this Three of Wands, I feel like you're definitely looking for a better situation. And I feel like you're not backing down until you find it. You're not giving up. You are, you know, setting those boundaries, you're setting your walls, your walls high so that, you know, nothing can enter that's not invited. Okay, that's the words that I'm getting. You're setting those wands high so nothing can get in that's not invited. Okay, so I feel like that's very interesting here. Okay, with this Three of Cups, I feel like, you know, there's something in your support system you're feeling isn't balanced. It may be someone close to you that you feel like may be betraying you, so you may feel the need to walk away from them. Maybe they're causing drama, or maybe you have found out that they're not as truthful as what you thought they were. So you're feeling the need to just, you know, let those Three Cups go. Because look at this. We have Three of Cups here. Here we have Three Cups that are spilt over, and you're keeping two, you know? So you're letting these Three of Cups go. You're letting this, you know, whoever this is that you felt like may have supported you, they may have betrayed you. So you're letting those cups go, and you're keeping you know, what is most valuable to you, what you find the most important, okay? And that's these two cups back here, okay? And I feel like you're moving into, you know, a more pleasant, more calm space, you know, because we're moving from the Five of Pentacles into something better, into, you know, being more assertive, being more happy, more focused. And, you know, this may also be some kind of communication that's going to become clear about what you feel is lacking from your life or from your situation. What you feel is not real is what I'm getting. But I feel like you're going to receive some kind of communication. Someone wants to speak to you, or you're taking quick action to move away from that, okay? And with this Four of Cups energy, I feel like there's still some things, because see here in this Four of Cups energy, he's daydreaming. He's deep in thought. But I feel like being so deep in thought, overthinking the situation, is pushing you into a lot of doubt. But in this Nine of Swords, she's not being overcome by the doubt. She's actually battling the demons that are in her nightmares. So I feel like, you know, I feel like you may be overthinking the situation now. You may be in doubt, but I feel like you're battling those feelings of doubt. And I feel like you are going to overcome, okay? Because I feel like you may be thinking more positive. You may be thinking more grateful. You may be finding your balance, okay? Because I feel like this Queen of Swords energy, you know, if there's love, if you're open to love, I feel like love is coming in for you. You know, there's something that is going to make you very happy in this situation. You have this, you have this sun here. Look at that. You know, so you're in pursuit of your happiness. And I feel like you're going to find that. You're going to find your happiness. Okay? Because I feel like you're focused. This love situation is going to make you very happy. You know, it's going to become more clear. You're going to have a better understanding. That sword is really sticking out to me on this Lover's card. So I feel like, you know, what is becoming clear is that you are in love with this person. But this person is in love with you. That's all they can think about. Okay? And I feel like it's happiness that you're pursuing. Okay. So, okay. Let's get an outcome for Virgo. Let's get an outcome for the situation, please. What do we need to tell Virgo for the situation, spirit? Message for Virgo. Okay. We have the Queen of Swords again. The Four of Swords. And the Six of Cups. Okay. At the bottom, we have the King of Pentacles. So you're finding your balance. You're finding your stability. This may be also, if this is a job situation, this may also be you gaining more wealth here, because we have the Queen of Pentacles as well. So the King of Pentacles showed up. So it may be an earth sign that's coming into your life to bring you more stability with this Lover's card. Okay. But take it how it resonates there. So I feel like with this Queen of Swords and this Four of Swords, you're gaining some clarity on the situation. You're finding a full understanding. Look at this. She is looking towards the future. She has her back against the past. She's not looking back at the past. The past is dead and gone. She's just focused on the future and focused on what is going to bring her happiness. You know, what is going to bring her that clarity. Okay. We have the Four of Swords. So I feel like there may be a blessing in disguise for you. This can also mean that you are focused on yourself and on feeling regenerized, rejuvenated, totally feeling relaxed, finding your balance, okay? We also have the Six of Cups. So there may be something that you're thinking about. Something may be coming back to give you a surprise visit, or you may be visiting a familiar place. Maybe it's a homecoming, you know, maybe you're traveling back home, but I feel like you're going to be surrounded by family and friends, people who love and care about you. Okay. The Six of Cups can also be viewed as a blessing or a gift. So there may be a blessing or a gift coming towards you, that you may not be expecting, especially with this King of Pentacles here. This King of Pentacles wants to bring you stability, you know, and wealth. So there may be an older person bringing you some kind of stability or wealth, okay? So that's what I have for you. We're going to go ahead and get an angel card for you, Virgo. Let's see what the angels have to say to Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising, and Venus. Okay. We have donations, tithings, and charitable work. So this may be this gift here. You know, someone may be donating something to you. Give joyfully to the organizations and people who spiritually support and inspire you, and know that your generosity will be returned to you manyfold in a miraculous way. The time, supplies, money, and other resources you donate will ensure that your positive energy multiplies. Okay. Interesting, Virgo. Let's get a manifestation moonology card. What do we have for Virgo? Okay, this one. Take inspired action. Full moon in Virgo. Yeah, this is your card, Virgo. Okay, so Spirit wants you to take inspired action and focus on the positive. Okay, so that's New Moon in Sagittarius. And last but not least, we're going to go ahead and get an angel number for you. So see what angel number you have and what that signifies for you. I can't speak this morning. I've been up all night, so now this morning I'm kind of drained. Okay, let's get an angel card. Okay, we have, wow, destiny. 111. Follow what you feel. Listen as your intuition helps to guide you to what you are manifesting. The inner whispers are helping you to create all that is that you desire. Listen, lean in, and follow your soul. Your affirmation, Virgo, is life is always happening for you. I am allowing myself to lean in to what feels good. Okay? Now, if this reading resonates, in the comment section, I want you to type 111. Listen, lean in, and follow your soul. Okay? Beautiful energy, Virgo. Okay? Now, if this reading resonates, please like and subscribe. Hit that bell so that you don't miss any uploads. And take a look at your Sun, Moon, and Rising. I have the March readings all in the playlist to make it easy for you. So take a look at your Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. And until your next reading, Virgo, many, many blessings to you. Love and light.